Chapter 1, Bethlehem. The two times my feet struggled to move forward are the most significant and life-changing moments of my life. The first moment when I was 5 years old, listening to the words of Pastor Green give an altar call. In a small church called Mount Zion AME on the north side of Atlanta, I was frozen in place as the opportunity for salvation was being offered. The other moment was the day I proposed to my wife. In both moments, I was entering into a covenant. I was entering into relationships that would forever change the way that I maneuvered through life. Looking back, I'm extremely grateful to know that these were the only moments I have ever forgotten how to walk. As my legs seem nailed to the floor, I'm confident that I've counted the cost of the steps I eventually took. And because of these steps, the Lord has graciously allowed me to influence the walk of many others. Music has always been a part of my life. I grew up in a musical family. My mom was a rapper, and my dad sang in the men's choir. My grandpa played guitar on the radio, and my siblings and I grew up singing in the children's choir at church. We weren't a part of ordinary children's choirs. We were like young superstars on tour. If you grew up in a black church in Atlanta, you may already know what I'm talking about. AME churches in Georgia went hard for their children's choirs. Imagine 30 kids squeezing into church vans to drive to the next revival service. I can still remember how amazing it felt singing to God in those purple and gold robes. Life at home was full of music too. Some of my favorite memories are Saturday mornings as the entire family cleaned the house while my mom played music from the entertainment center. I'm still convinced that music makes you clean better. Some nights it was my mom cooking while music was playing through the house. Other times it was my parents in the living room stepping. Sometimes it was all of us gathered around the TV with the volume muted as we had the music playing. And then there were the times where my family sat listening to me on the speakers. Whatever day you happened to visit the Hamilton home, music was usually our permanent guest. I released my first album at 11 years old, but I began doing music at the age of 8. My mom started taking me to the studio at a young age, and my parents were always driving me to perform all over Atlanta. It was a beautiful era of listening to V103 announce a new talent competition while we leaned in close to the radio to figure out where I'd be performing next. Atlanta is in the Bible Belt, meaning that it was a city that supported its youth most strongly,